Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another H1Z1 video. Now today, as always, we are playing some Ignition. And yeah, I've already made a couple episodes of this, so you guys should know how the game works. So I'm just gonna just get into the whole commentating of things. So we landed near a small little town. Not really the best spawn ever, but it's a decent spawn. So let's go check inside this house. There's two ATVs, one that I just threw, and there's one by the side of the house. So if someone does do something tricky, like try to take my spark plugs, I'll be able to take that second ATV. We have managed to find a shotgun, which will help us a little bit. Me, just personally, I don't really like the shotgun. So, me, I don't know, I very much prefer an AR, obviously. Anyone would prefer an AR, or maybe even a better pistol. I'm not even kidding, that's how much I don't like really the shotgun. I would probably take a Magnum or an M9 above it, but I guess we'll just stick with the shotgun. Let's keep looting the house, make sure we get everything, because we will probably start fighting some people soon if we manage to go anywhere. There's some loud wind. Thought maybe that was another ATV, but it's not. Alright, so let's see what we can do. Doesn't look like there's people here, which is kind of a good thing, kind of a bad thing. We want some other people here so I can kill and take their stuff, but at the same time, I don't feel like getting killed yet because I don't have any good stuff. But there is a Magnum, which will help us quite a lot. And we did manage to find ourselves a military backpack, which will be good because we'll be able to hold a lot of stuff. Now, quickly, let's check these houses. And once we check these houses, we should start heading there. I'm just going to hope there's an AR in here. If there's not, we might have to just go to the safe zone with a shotgun and a Magnum. It's just what we might have to deal with. And there's not very good chances of an AR being in here, which is not very good, but let's hope that there might be something in here, and it does not look like it, sadly, but that's okay. We'll get to loot some other places, or we might just kill someone with the shotgun. Of course, a gun is still a gun, we can still use it, grab some else's stuff. It's just gonna be a lot harder to control this ATV, clearly, but it's just gonna be a lot harder because I'm gonna have to really get close to them, and if they have an AR, they'll probably be able to shoot me from far away. But quickly, let's get this house real quick. I'm gonna hope again that this house has an AR. This is probably gonna be one of the last houses I check for now until I get a little bit closer to the safe zone. But ooh, an AK. Alright, you know what, that is a gun that will, I'm completely fine with going to the safe zone with an AK, to be honest, because it's different than the AR. I've used them in past episodes. Its spray is harder to control, but it is automatic, unlike the AR, and I think it does do a little bit more damage, because the game developers, because they recently patched the AK, in the beginning it was super strong, then they nerfed it, and recently they buffed it again. They say that it can now shoot faster than the AR, so people will start using the AK again, but a lot of people out there can shoot the AR very, very fast. So, yeah, I don't know how that, but yeah, the AK is fun. It's a little bit harder to control, but if you do master it, it can be a way better gun than the AR, because the AK is primarily used for very up-close combat because it shoots so quick and it just sprays everywhere. With the AR, you can kind of find yourself missing and potatoing. With the AK, it's spray and pray. You can find yourself hitting shots no matter what you do. So very close range, it's better than the AR. Long range, the AR is better. But if you can master long range with the AK, you'll be able to not even just shoot far away, but super up close, which the AR isn't very good. It's not what it's meant to do. So that's why the AK can be amazing if it's in the right hands. But other than that, we don't have to use our shotgun anymore, which is a very good thing. We can stick to the AK, and hopefully I'll be able to do something with it. Now, the circles are pretty close to me, and we still have 4 minutes to kill. So maybe we can go in there, maybe get a couple kills, see what we can do about it. But yeah, let's try not to crash the ATV on the way there. The only thing that I'm missing is either a laminated armor or an AR. An AR would be nice because, of course, AKs are a little bit more rare than ARs, so I tend to practice the AR quite a lot and not so much the AK. But the AR isn't necessary, but what is necessary is laminated. And when I say necessary, I don't really mean necessary, because I can still win very easily without it. I just need to not get shot. A laminated can soak up one or two shots, which can help quite a lot, or it can save you from a shotgun, because without a laminated, a shotgun can one-pump you. If the guy gets lucky and hits you straight in the chest or head. Laminated can save you from that, but yeah, if we're taking a look at the safe zone, it's very, very flat. There's a couple hills, but yeah, this is a very dangerous safe zone, especially for me, since a lot of people are going to have cars and I have an ATV. They can get out of their car anytime and have cover, but I'm stuck on an ATV, very wide open. And this is the type of safe zone, like I said, it's very flat and open and they can shoot me from almost anywhere from. There's really nowhere to hide other than these bushes, but only noobs. Oh, wow, there's a person right there. Now, he did not manage to hit me, but he is shooting at me with an AR, so now we do know he has an AR. There is a second ATV player. Now, we will see what we can do here. They're fighting. We'll be able to kill one of them, for sure. Let's just spray our AK, see if we can do anything. Not trying to be very precise here, but alright, one of them died. It doesn't look like this one knows that we're here. So I guess we can just kind of spray at him, and there we go. Let's shoot him a couple more times for fun. Yep, he is dead. Now that was kind of cheap. I did pick off the last, or they had a fight and I picked him off. But then again, he really should have been smarter, in my opinion, that if he was fighting a dude, the other guy, I'm pretty sure, had an AR. I was shooting an AK. You should be able to hear the difference between an AR and an AK. And with hearing two types of guns, you should be able to know that there is a second person. And lying down in a bush like that probably isn't the best idea. Now, of course, he probably didn't know my position because he was in the middle of a battle. But either way, whatever. He's dead. And the whole spraying with AK, I missed every shot with that AK spray. But I guess I really wasn't. I could have probably aimed a little bit better and shot them, but that really wasn't my intention. I was just kind of spraying and praying, see if I could hit anything. Either way, I was gonna kind of wait until both of them had their fights ended, because that was the best outcome possible. If I would have tried to fight both of them, I would have died 100%. Even though I probably could have killed one of them, the other guy would have maybe not have been damaged, and he could have came and got me. I think it's better that one of them killed each other and I could pick off the last guy. In the end, it won't be as cool for me because I won't have as many kills, but for safe play, it's a safer play for me to do. Now, yeah, this dude has an AR, so we're gonna take this AR and we're gonna use it. It only has 30 bullets, but you know what, 30 bullets is just enough to kill somebody. So yeah, we do have a good amount of loot. We have a couple of extra helmets in case we get headshotted. We do have some Molotovs, tactical first aid kits. Really, again, all we need is armor, and we're pretty much set. Now, those two guys, so let me loot the other guy, see if he has anything. And he doesn't really have anything that we need. Only thing that I would pick up anymore is maybe tactical first aid kits. That's legitimately the only thing. Now, there's a car up there. Now, this car might be able to kill us if he rushes us, but at the same time, if he rushes us, I will have a very open position to shoot him through the window, considering he's going to be coming for me. He could try to hit me long range, but the thing is, I do still have a little bit of a hill that I can hide behind my ATV, so that's pretty good. Now, there's an airdrop to our front left, front right, I don't know, you guys can see, it's the purple smoke. Now, there is a car up on the hill that I see. So I need to be careful of that car, but it should be coming near us. If he was a very aggressive player, he will come towards us. But I do want to, there's a police car over there I do want to be careful of, in case he has a sniper from a different crate. He could just take my head off, or if he's just a good aimer with the AR in general. But yeah, if one of these guys pushed us, I actually wouldn't really be mad. Okay, so we got to go to that circle, it's near the mountains. Even if one of these guys pushed, I wouldn't be that mad, because I do need more supplies. I'm still looking for ammo. So the dude over there wants to get the crate, but pretty sure he sees me. And he might be coming after me. But I am behind my ATV, so even if he tried to run me over, he can't do that. Let's try to hit him. We hit him once. We hit him twice. Alright, we gotta go for him. I ran out of ammo, but we do still have our AK. Let's go. We only have 21 shots left. Now, what happened there, guys, is that was actually very, very calculated. If you guys saw, I stood behind my ATV specifically because I knew with a car, he would try to run me over. But if you're behind a vehicle, you can't really do that. Now, this guy's standing still for some reason, so let's just shoot him. And bam, he's gone. So, I don't know what his thought process there of just standing there. Honestly, I potatoed a little bit. If you guys noticed, those first couple shots I actually did miss because I sprayed. just need her to calm down a bit. But yeah, he has some AK ammo and AR ammo, so that is perfect. I only had 21 shots left, guys, so that's very useful. I would have ran out of ammo if I didn't kill this guy. So that is perfect. Let's reload all our guns. So now, yeah, like I said, if you guys ever find a car that's just rushing at you, get behind something, or you can just try your luck and jump, but jumping doesn't always work. In that situation, I would have 100% been dead if I wasn't hiding behind that ATV. Of course, he was dumb, he just hit the ATV stopped him, and I ended up getting two headshots on him, or not two headshots, because I would have killed him. I got one headshot, and no, I take all my words back. I didn't even get a headshot, because his helmet would have been off. His helmet was still on when I killed him. I hit him twice in the neck, or shoulders, so that brought him down very probably around 50%. And then, of course, he had to heal before he bled out. So that's why I'm guessing he stopped by the houses. He didn't think I was going to chase him. And I don't know if he was just listening to loud music and he didn't hear me coming behind him with the ATV. But there is another guy here. Let's try to kill. I don't know if he knows we're here. Yeah, he does. He's hiding. Oh, no. Potato, please. All right, we got him, boys. We got him. All right, one more shot should kill him. One more shot. There we go. It took off his helmet. Now I'm down to 15% health, so we really should heal. Heal. All right, we'll be completely fine. Now, yeah. So he was probably trying to heal by the houses, and I don't know if he didn't hear me, but yeah. Now this guy over here, I saw him from the hill that I was riding down. Now, he didn't initially see me, but I guess he heard my ATV when I got pretty close. Now this guy should have easily gotten the advantage because he was on the hill above me, and he had a car to hide behind. This guy 100% should have killed me, but I got pretty lucky with some of that AK spray, and I did end up hitting him a couple times. I'm guessing he got pretty scared, and he panicked, he potatoed, and I killed him. He did get me down to 15%. One more shot from him would have killed me, but we did pretty good. Now, that's three people dead already. Now, we do need to make it to the safe zone. We've got about 2 minutes, and you can actually see the safe zone above the hill. So we'll be completely fine. As long as we don't go up the hill, accidentally go too steep and fall back, blow up our car, that'd be the only way we don't make it, but I'm sure we'll be fine. Now, there are three players alive left. Me, and I'm gonna speculate that the other two are already on top of the hill. So I do have to be careful here. Make sure I don't run into somebody and get headshotted. That does happen a lot. Alright, so the thing... Oh, and there's a guy right there. Oh, no. Alright, well, I think he's pretty much a potato. He can't hit me. And my car is pretty sporadic right now. I'm kind of going left and right very quickly. He won't be able to hit me. Alright, but I have located one. There's one by the car over there, and he is shooting one on top of the hill. So my speculation was correct. One guy is right in front of me on the hill. The other one is on top of the mountain. So now I do know where both of them are. That gives me a little bit of an advantage. Now this guy's going to come for me. Now he... Well, I don't think he knew I was here or something, but yeah, he's going to be gone. Now, since there's another dude on top of the mountain, I'm guessing those two will have a fight in a second. Unless that dude's going to be very passive and just run away. But, you know what? We probably should head up there ourselves a little bit. I hear shots. One of them is dead. Now, let's go for the win. There's one guy left. Let's go and try to kill him. He's probably above this mountain somewhere. He is right there. And, oh, no. I got launched. And we won. Okay, let's look at a replay of that because that was crazy. I didn't even have to kill him. I hit him with my car. Yeah, my car launched me, which was bad, but then this happened. So if you guys see, my car actually hit him. I didn't even have to hit him. Okay, guys, so you might be wondering what's going on, or you might be confused right now on why there's more H1Z1 gameplay. Well, today is going to be a little bit special because I do have a second game for you guys. Now, this game's a little bit different because this game is very, very terrible, but at the same time, very, very good. I actually won this game with zero kills. I did not have to touch a single person to win this game. But that's exactly why you guys can see it's obviously very, very fast-forwarded, because I don't want to show you guys a game that I don't do anything in. It'd be like a 20-minute game that I do nothing. So what I'm going to do is I'm just speeding this up. It's going to be done maybe in the next 2 minutes, but I'm going to kind of just talk about the game while this 2 minutes goes on, and I'll show you guys what happens. But yeah, in this game, I literally just pick up an ATV, find a car, pick up a car, head to the save zone, and by the time I'm really to the last save zone, there's only three people left, me and two other dudes. And when I get there, the two dudes are fighting, and they end up trading. If you guys don't know what trading means, it literally means where two people are shooting at each other, and they both get themselves so low that they both end up dying. Usually one kills the other, but he is so low, he's at like 5%, and he ends up bleeding out before he can heal, and they both die. That doesn't happen very often, but it just so happened to happen in a top three, and I ended up just taking it. I don't have to do anything. So now I'm here, I'm hiding on top of a mountain here, actually. Because here's the safe zone now. Someone's gonna soon start shooting at me, which I'm gonna leave, but yeah, guys, this is literally the entire game. I just run around with a car until, and honestly, I swear, I do not even mean for this to happen. I wanted to kill people, but none of them ever showed up. None of them ever came to me, and I don't think even I have any good guns, so yeah, this game is very, very, very exciting. Now, as you can see, there are only four people left. I've literally seen maybe one or two people, and there's already only four left, so it's already a top four situation. Now, in the game, I try to go to this house, so maybe I can find a gun, and I end up finding a pistol. So yeah, I'm going into probably a final circle with only a pistol, which is not, obviously, if you guys know anything about this game, is not good, because someone's gonna have an AR, and they will shoot the crap out of me. But yeah, the circle is pretty far away, so we should find our way there. But first, I'm going to check these houses, just maybe for luck of an AR. But it does not seem like I'm going to find an AR once again. So yeah, oh, and there's an AR. Oh, yeah, this video is going so fast, because I'm actually commentating over this. Obviously, I'm not going to commentate this entire game, because it'd be way too boring for you guys. But yeah, I end up searching through these houses. I do find an AR, which I won't even get to use because, like I said, I don't even touch a single person this entire game. Now, when the end of the game comes up, I will slow it or make it back to normal speed so you guys can kind of just see the trade. But yeah, we need one more minute and we need to get to the safe zone. But the car is on fire. You guys can see here. I end up launching my car, just hiding behind a tree. And here comes the normal. You guys see there's three people left. They shoot at each other and they end up killing each other. And that's just the game right there. That's it. Well, guys, if you did enjoy this, make sure to like and comment as a sportsman channel, and I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.